depth of the southern hemisphere nights, we notice two bright eyes staring at us. Their celestial presence pierced darkness, drawing us into contemplating the mysteries of the universe. These are the Magellanic Clouds.
Okay, she doesn't want to be on camera today, but we're talking about the Magellanic Clouds, two beautiful galaxies that we really got into recently. We're using a teleprompter. Hello! That's your line first, so I'm gonna wait here.
Okay. We created this one in June 2023 in the cold winter of the Atacama Desert. The temperature was below freezing point and I can still feel it in my bones.
It was cold. We noticed the Magellanic Clouds 6 years ago, not that far from here in Bolivia. And we kept capturing these galaxies, but always combined with the Milky Way. This time, we wanted to make them shine on their own.
I hope they're happy about that.
No, they don't care. Is it me? No, that's you.
Oh, that's me.
Are we going to keep all these stupid...
Of course, yeah, it's okay. A one take. The Magellanic Clouds are two irregular dwarf galaxies. That's hard to say.
She dropped her food. We said no cut.
The Magellanic Clouds are two irregular dwarf galaxies visible from the southern hemisphere. They are named after the Portuguese explorer Ferdinand Magellan, who observed them during his voyage around the world in early 16th century. The large Magellanic Cloud is about 160,000 light years away from Earth and is roughly 14,000 light years in diameter. That's big. It contains several hundred million stars. The small Magellanic Cloud is about 200,000 light years from Earth and is much smaller than its counterpart. Both galaxies are gravitationally bound to the Milky Way and are considered satellites to our galaxy, which means they orbit around it. Well, basically, there are two dwarf galaxies. They orbit around the Milky Way, which means around our galaxy, which makes them easy to observe from here.
Yeah, and that's interesting because since we started to plan this video, I started to be very obsessed by the Magellanic Clouds, and I keep noticing them in some of our older shots that I didn't know because sometimes we see just one of the two. This is a typical circle. The way we capture the night sky and the light painting within a single image is something we learned over the years. I always expose for the background and I do the light painting quickly within that exposure. My exposure time is normally 8 seconds for this shot, but I wanted to grab more details in the night sky. So I went to 15 seconds. And when I told her 15 seconds, she said, no way.
I said, no, that's too long.
That's too long, especially at -5 degrees.
Yeah.
Now that's a bit risky as no one can stay still for that long. Even Kim Henry, trying to learn how to use a teleprompter. She's doing the hard work. So I tried something a bit unusual. I set my second camera to 4 seconds, which would be enough to capture... Scroll!
There's a delay!
Scroll!
Oh, sorry. I thought you would do the previous one. No cut. Let's keep going.
Trying to be professional. So I tried something a bit unusual. I set my second camera to 4 seconds, which would be enough to capture the light painting and keep a much better quality. That means a bit more editing, matching the two, but the end result is so much better. That doesn't change a thing if you look at the picture on a smartphone, but for a large print, it is quite satisfying to get that level of details. This is the Atacama Desert in Chile, so it's cold at night, but the main challenge is to figure out a great composition when we're in total darkness. I scout with no flashlight and I simply look at the overall composition of the stars in relation to the rocks that are in front of me. So I see black rocks and then the stars above. So I'm trying to find kind of a dip somewhere where I could place Kim just above the horizon. Once I find something that is potentially interesting, I ask Kim to go in the scene and then I quickly test my framing by doing short exposures at super high ISO. As usual with the stars, my flashlight is set on a very low brightness. I use a solid pinkish tube, that's this one right here. I love using this color on these brownish rocks. Pink is my favorite color.
No, it's actually my favorite color. We shot the landscape at 14 millimeters. The close-up was at 50 millimeters.
Yeah, your face is at 15.
Yeah, f1.8, ISO 3200, and 15 seconds of exposure.
Just notice that we didn't write the settings for the close-up camera. So as I'm using a 50 millimeters f1.2, I went down to f1.2 so I could lower the ISO to 1600 and then get a cleaner image.
The white balance was at 3200 and it was 4:48 a.m.
Why are we doing this?
Well, it was worth it, wasn't it?
That's the conclusion?
Yeah. Okay, bye.
What you don't see on camera is my bordel. Okay, I think you have enough stupid footage.